I'm Chucky. Wanna play?
What up, y'all? Back at y'all again with another episode of 16 Bars, man. We want to thank everybody for joining the show. Yet another episode. Old Books is here with us today.
Yes, sir, man. Out here. Survival. Shout out to Davies. That's how I feel right now.
Alright.
Surviving?
That's it. Had above water like a duck.
So how the guy?
Duck's whole body's
above water.
Right. But I'm on some duck shit right now.
So how the guy? What's up?
Just happy, man.
You ready for the episode?
I'm ready.
Alright. Before we start the episode, we're going to take a look at Fight Club. Y'all, Fight Club is looking real good. Hey, y'all. Y'all out there, if y'all go ahead and leave a message, let us know in the comments down below what y'all think about Fight Club. Go back and watch the other episodes. Let us know what y'all think should be in Fight Club. All right, so yo, oh, what we got?
Number 5, Slick Rick, The Great Adventures of Slick Rick. Number 4, Lost Boys, Legal
Jamaica
Drummer.
Queens in the house.
Number 3, Kanye West, College Dropout.
That's Salon's homeboy.
Number 2, The Fugees, The Score.
Lauryn Hill.
And number one, Method Man's Cal.
18 weeks in.
Wu-Tang Clan's own, man, Johnny Bliss.
Honestly, this is a good list of albums, though.
No, this is a great list of albums, though.
I mean, they're pretty.
You should have these 5 albums in your catalog.
And if you don't, you should at least stream them or have heard them. Because if you haven't heard them or streamed them now, then I don't know what you're doing with it.
All right, well, yo, you know how you always start the show. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, go on down, hit the subscription button, hit the bell notifications to get notified for all the new content we're dropping. Don't forget to tell a friend. Tell a family member, share the page, yo. I mean, thank you all for joining every week. Sai,
yes.
Where are we going this week, man?
The Third Coast.
The Third Coast?
What's the Third Coast?
Isn't it east and west?
And it's the third coast.
Is that really considered the Third Coast?
If going look where at everything it, it's is third big coast. Down there. Big on everything.
What album are we going with this week, Sai?
We're going with the Geto Boys, No Way Out.
What, no, we can't be stopped.
What the hell is going on? No Way Out.
So before the album, before we start the album, O wants to say something before.
Oh no,
we start.
I mean I would have said it during the album, but as we're recording now, there's word that Bushwick Bill is like on life support, so we're gonna set our prayers out to him and his family.
Prayers going out
because you know he's dealing with stage 4, I think pancreatic cancer.
Yeah.
So he. It's not a, you know, they already reported, like, Scarface, a few other people said rest in peace, but his son, Bushwick Bill's son, has said he has not died yet. He's still on life support fighting for his life, so
we're going to. All right, prayers go out prayers up for to him. The family. All right, so, y'all, like Sai just said, this album is called We Can't Be Stopped from the Geto Boys. This album was released on July 9th, 1991, wow. Early in the hip-hop age. Album has 14 tracks on there, guys. Let's go with length of the album. Album length. What you got, Sai?
How many tracks?
14 tracks.
I'd say let's go 61 minutes.
61 minutes? Oh, what you got?
Let's go 55.
55 minutes. Length of the album is 51 minutes and 45 seconds. Everybody went over. Yo, whack. Record label, Rap-A-Lot Records, which is home of... What's his name?
Prince.
Right. Producers and on the album?
Who? I don't know who else. I mean, it's most of the Houston rappers were on Rap-A-Lot at the time.
Okay, okay.
They're still signed to Rap-A-Lot. To this day, actually.
Okay. Producers on the album? Bushwick Bill, James Smith, John Dito, Johnny C, Roland, Scarface himself, Simon, and also Willie D.
Remember that Biggie line where he said... Not from Houston,
but I rap a lot. Threw it in there. Yo, so first track of the album is called Rebel Rap Family. And we're going to jump over that track. But before we jump over that side, do you know the 3 members of Geto Boys?
You got Bushwick Bill, Willie D, and...
Mr. Scarface himself?
Scarface himself.
All right.
Shout out to Bushwick Bill. He's Jamaican.
A lot of mercy.
They tried to deport him back in 2001, 2002. Yeah, they tried to deport him. Yeah. And either 2001 or 2002. I remember that.
9/11?
I remember that. Oh, wow. I remember that time. Yo, track number 2. We have We Can't Be Stopped. And
that's the title track of the album.
The title track of the album. I want to ask you a question while we're here. 1991. Are they the fathers of Southern hip-hop?
We started out before Outkast, which
is
true.
And this is their second album. So they had an album before this.
Yeah, 89. Yeah, I would say so. Who was from the South?
Off the top of the head, I really can't think.
I don't think they're...
They've been doing it for a while from the South. And they've been repping the South. They've been talking about the South in their albums this time.
Big Texas. Yeah. So, yeah, they probably are.
Leave us a comment down below what y'all think, man. Track number 3 on the album is called Homie Don't Play That. And isn't that from that that TV show?
And
Living Color. Homie Don't Play. So this is where they got that from? Homie Don't Play That. This is where they got that.
I mean, I don't know if they got it from that, but they had the Homie Don't Play That Clown by Nate Wiggins, hit you with the damn.
All right. So while we're here, let's give us some Billboard chart numbers, man. When the album dropped on the Billboard 200, it reached as high as number 24. So 1991, Billboard 200.
200, that's pretty good.
It hit 24.
Because think about it, hip-hop wasn't even really, like, it was there, but it wasn't there, like, 91. To hit number 24.
And then on the R&B album charts, it hit number 5.
Wow.
So, pretty good. Early in 1991. Track number 4 on the album, Another Jigger in the Morgue. We got to do a verse off of this, because this has a nice verse. What verse you want to do for this, Si?
Going to do the second
verse?
Second verse.
All right, let's get this here.
Who's the Scarface?
Yeah.
It's going to be a killing after midnight. Niggas getting ready for a big fight. You can say this one's a murder by a lunatic. Hear me living on your ass, bitch. Yo, the way they come across is like...
Very vulgar and very in your straightforward.
Yo, not for nothing, though. Willie D and Scarface, their voices sound kind of similar when they talk, like when they rap. You know what I'm saying?
Not all the way, but like a heavy voice.
Their two is like... I be like looking like, all right, who's this one? Yeah,
on
a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
I didn't know who was this one when I heard it. The inch, like,
only Bushwick Bill sounds different. You know his voice.
Yeah, you know his voice when you hear it. Right.
Loading up my weapons, getting ready for another street sweeping. Neighborhood drug war. Police come around in the meat wagon, knowing that tonight they'll be dragging off motherfuckers to a 6-foot ditch. I hope your insurance paid up, bitch. That's tonight's the night, motherfucker. Be a good killer.
Girl, hold on. Ooh, that's a big line of hip hop. Tonight's the night. Yeah.
Which one came
Redman. No, Redman came after.
Yeah, this
Redman is. Came 96 or 97, Redman.
Nah, Redman Muddy like Waters. 94.
Well, Redman definitely came after this.
This is 91, right?
Yeah. I hope your insurance paid up, bitch, because tonight's the night, motherfucker. Be a good killer or a damn good ducker. Because if you ain't, your ass is falling to the paint. Bloodshed seems to make a nigga faint. Not me with a 9 in my hand. I could fall asleep laying next to a dead man.
Mm. That's fucked up.
That's tough, though, for you to be able to sit.
Nigga's comfortable, man.
Yo, let's get into it, man. This is track number 4, man. That's this track is called Another Jigger in the Mall, man. Whose verse is this, huh?
Scarface.
Let's get it.
Yo, let me finish this freestyle though, man. Hold him down, hold him up, yo. It's gonna be a killing after midnight. Niggas getting ready for the big fight. You can say this one's a murder by a lunatic. Hit me living on your ass, bitch. Loading up our weapons, getting ready for another street sweeping neighborhood drug war. Police come around in a meat wagon, knowing that tonight they'll be dragging off motherfuckers to a 6-foot ditch. I hope your insurance paid up, bitch. Cause tonight is the night, motherfucker. Be a good killer or a damn good ducker. Cause if you ain't, your ass is falling to the paint. Bloodshed seems to make a nigga faint. Not me with a 9 in my hand. I can fall asleep lying next to a dead man. You gotta understand me. It's better that sorry motherfucker laying out dead, see. So if you wanna come hard, or you'll be another nigga in the morgue. Yeah, you motherfuckers going for bad and shit, you know what I'm saying? But you'll be another nigga no more, motherfucker. Oh, yo, check this out.
Yeah. So, yo, let's move on. Track number 5 on the album is called Chucky. And while we on Chucky, he was actually talking. This was, what's his name? Bushwick Bill. Mm-hmm. Talking about him being Chucky the Doll, which it's kind of weird, right? He's short, Chucky's short. He's crazy, Chucky's crazy.
Him and Chucky's same height.
But while we're here, man, let's talk about singles. Let's jump into singles, yo. We're going to do singles. This week, there was only
one
single. Who wants to go? Oh, what's the single
on
this?
My mind's playing tricks. That's
a cheat. That's a cheat, though, because that was the hottest track on this album.
It's still a hot track.
Yo, it's a classic track.
It's still a reference, yo. All
right, so Oh got the one track.
And it's only right that I'm going to be the one that says it.
And the next track on the album is called...
Hey, and guess what?
My mind playing tricks.
I'm the one that got it, so I get to say it. Thank you.
Track number 6.
And we're going to go verse 2 by Willie D.
Oh, let's get it. All right.
I make big money.
I make big cars.
Everybody know me.
It's like I'm a movie star.
But late at night, something ain't right. I feel like I'm being tailed by the same sucker headlights. Is it that fool that I ran off the block? Or is it that nigga last week
that I shot?
Or is it that one I beat for $5,000? Thought he had a cane, but it was gold
metal flower. Ooh. Hold up. Did a lot of people get caught back in the day?
You got to taste it first. On the spot, Poppy. Let me see.
Don't taste the top.
Gold metal.
Gold metal flower. Reach under my seat, grab my papa for the suckers. Ain't no use to be lying. I was scared than a motherfucker. Hooked the left into Popeyes and bailed out quick. Popeyes wasn't around in New York back then, though.
But that was down south.
Because you know we had Roy Rogers back in the day.
Yeah.
Roy Rogers was like...
We didn't even have Church Chicken yet either.
No, nah, but Roy Rogers was like Popeyes back in the day. Okay, chicken. You ever had Roy Rogers?
Yeah, they were banging.
You still got one or two?
They were banging.
The only one I know, I don't know if it's still there, is across the Madison Square Garden.
Wow. In the city. I don't even think it's there anymore.
I jumped on Church Chicken late too. I wasn't on it early.
As soon as you jumped on, you're supposed to jump right the fuck off. Yo. It wasn't all that good. It still ain't all that good.
I was scared in the motherfucker. Hooked the left in the Popeyes and bailed out quick. If it's going down, let's get this shit over with. Here they come, just like I figured. I got my hand on my motherfucking trigger. What I saw make your ass start giggling. Three blind, crippling, crazy
senior citizens.
I live by the sword. I take my boys everywhere I go because I'm paranoid. I keep looking over my shoulder and peeping around corners. My mind is playing tricks.
So, yo, go check out this video later on when you finish this episode, man. Yo, this is track number 6. Whose verse is this,
oh? Willie D.
Yo, Willie D, this is Mind Playing Tricks on Me, y'all.
I make big money, I drive big cars, everybody know me. It's like I'm a movie star, but late at night, something ain't right. I feel I'm being tailed by the same sucker's headlights. Is it that fool that I ran off the block? Or is it that nigga last week that I shot? Or is it the one I beat for $5,000? Thought he had cane, but it was gold, metal flower. Reached under my seat, grab my papa for the suckers. Ain't no use to me lying, I was scared of a motherfucker. Put the left in the Popeyes and bail down quick. If it's going down, let's get this shit over with. Here they come, just like I figured. I got my hand on the motherfucking trigger. When I saw him, make your ass start giggling. Three blind, crippling, crazy senior citizens. I live by the sword. I take my boys everywhere I go because I'm paranoid. I keep looking over my shoulder and peeping around corners. My mind is playing tricks on me.
Yo, ill verse, man. But while we here, man, we gonna pay some tribute to Bushwick Bill, man.
We gonna
give y'all.
This was the memorable verse.
Yeah? This is the memorable verse.
So this is the best verse on this song?
Yeah, I mean it's the most.
I mean, it's the one. Yeah, it's the one.
You can visualize it.
You can visualize it. Bushwick Bill, whatever. He's like, this year Halloween fell on the weekend.
Me and Geto Boys trick or treating.
Robbing little kids for bags. So little man got behind our ass. So we speeded up the pace. Took a look back and he was right before our face. He being for a squabble, no doubt. So I swung and hit the nigga in his mouth. More like his kneecap.
So now that's what makes it so hilarious when he tried to
upside. He went upside.
No, he got knees.
At one point, it's like, yo, he had to stand up by 6 or 7 feet tall. And then he's like, wait a minute.
That's why, that's why you're measuring.
When you're 3 feet six, everybody's 6-7 feet tall.
So it's like, you picture him swinging, hitting him in the jaw. It's like,
so give us some more.
So I swung and hit him, the nigga, in his mouth. He was going down, we figured. But this was no ordinary nigga. He stood about 6-7 feet.
And that's the day I'm seeing him in my sleep.
So we teamed on him, dropping them motherfucking bees on him. The more I swung, the more blood flew. Then he disappeared.
And my boy disappeared too.
Then I just felt like a fiend.
It wasn't even close to Halloween.
It was dark as fuck on the streets, and my hands all bloody from punching
on the concrete.
Damn on me, my mind playing tricks on me.
Yo, so he was on some crazy ass drugs, thinking that he was actually fighting some dudes.
That's the nigga I was seeing in my sleep.
Yo, man, let's move on, man. We're going to move on to track number 7. Track number 7 is called I'm Not a Gentleman. Why are we on track number 7? What do you guys think about the cover? You know the story about the cover, O?
What's the story?
You know the story about the cover, Si?
Let me see what the cover looks
like. Take a look at the cover before.
Them holding him in the hospital?
So he was, the story, which what I read, he was with his girlfriend, and they were playing with a gun, and the gun ended up going off and shot in the eye. See, took him to the hospital. While he was in the hospital, they thought of the idea to unplug his water, what they call the IV, take off the patch off his eye,
and
roll him down the hallway, and take a picture, for the album. So this was a real event, and he said that this kind of traumatized him later down the line, because it always bothered him, like, yo, that was messed up for them to do a cover like that. He said, whenever he looks at that cover, he remembers, like, damn,
that
bro,
moment.
That was messed up that we did that.
They on the gurney.
And they convinced them to do it, too.
Oh, shit.
So that's crazy.
Nah, look, he on the phone. He got the trap phone. So I got, oh,
yeah.
Yeah,
they pulled the patch off his eye to get the picture. So, ill cover, but.
Dramatic.
Story behind that is crazy. Again, this is what I read. I don't know if it's 100% true. Don't kill me in the comments section, yo. Let's move on, man. Track number 8 is called Gotta Let Your Nuts Hang. This is another good track, oh. Let's do a verse off of this.
Yeah, I like this track.
Gotta Let Your Nuts Hang.
I'm gonna give it to
Sai. You like it when you don't give it to Sai?
I'm gonna give it to
Sai. Get Sai all the hot verses.
I do that when I sit on the toilet.
Ooh, whoa. That's too much info, bro.
It's everybody, you know? That's too much info. Bro, ain't no cuffing them. They just got
Let's get the verse, man. Right,
oh,
man.
keep it in the satchel.
It's just what it is. It's not too much info. It's life, man.
Whose verse you going with, Sai?
This goes with some Scarface.
All right.
You gotta let your nuts hang. Boom, boom, boom on your black ass, bitch.
Well, hold up. Who are you? I'm telling you. Oh, I know that line.
Somebody help him out. Boom, boom, boom on your black
ass. Either Ice Cube used that.
Eminem.
Eminem, man. No.
It's T. Don't go. No. Boom, boom, boom.
It's either Ice Cube.
Oh, no. That was Nicki Minaj. Boom, boom, boom.
No, man. Boom, Ice Cube. Yo, serious, man. Either Ice Cube or Master P.
What's the name? Chick from Black Eyed Peas.
Yo,
oh,
man.
She definitely used it.
Leave in the comments down below if y'all know where that came from. No. There's a crazy rap song. Boom, boom, boom on your black. I believe it's Ice Cube or. It's Master P. Let's go, Sai. Give us the verse, man. Bring it back.
Boom,
my
boom,
bad.
Boom on your black ass, bitch. Here's another hit from my shit. I made a couple of movies in the 5-0s where I smarted. Here's part 2 of how I started. Slanging them things on a dough cut. 5-0, I ride in my dick, but so what? What can you do to a nigga like Face? Mm. And why you sweating AK in the first place. AK? Who's that?
I think you're talking about a gun, but who knows?
And why you sweating AK in the first place? That's the motherfucking problem. See a young nigga rolling a Beamer and gotta stop him.
Mm-hmm.
But I'ma tell you like this, huh? All long men suck dick. Speak of yourself and try to bust you. But you can't die, motherfucker, cause bitch, I don't love you. You're making it harder on me, on my fellas. You're making it harder on my fellas. These dope fiend bitches and big drug sellers.
Mm.
How can you preach to the fiends that they should quit while Barry's up in Washington smoking that shit?
Mm.
You need to get yourself. Mm. Which Barry is that?
Hey, I ain't calling no names, man. There's a lot of Barrys. There's a lot of Barrys that passed away.
But that's 91.
The mayor of Washington? Isn't he smoking crack with...
No, that was later on down the line.
Yeah,
that was in the 2000s that happened.
Nah, it was another one. They had more than one. Because it got a track.
You got more than one mayor smoking crack. Yo, man, this is track number 8. This is called Let Your Nuts Hang, man. Who versus this side?
This is Scarface.
It's Scarface? Let's get it, yo.
Hurry up in Washington.
Boom, boom, boom on your black ass, bitch. Here's another hit from my shit. I made a couple of moves and 5-0 while I was smarted. Here's part 2 of how I started. Slanging them fangs on a dope cut. 5-0's a rod in my dick, but so what? What can you do to a nigga like Face? And why you sweating act in the first place? That's the motherfucking problem. See a young nigga rolling a beamer and gotta stop him. But I'ma tell you like this. All lawmen suck dick, sneaky as hell and try to bust ya. But you can die, motherfuckers, cause bitch, I don't love ya. You're making it harder on my fellas. These dope fiend bitches and the big drug sellers. How can you preach to the fiends that they should quit while Barry's up in Washington smoking that shit? You need to get yourself a life or keep trying, or more and more cops will be dying. Cause I am sick of seeing niggas being shortstop by a buck on fire, dick in the booty ass cop. You figure you're hard cause you're a cop, see? Fuck with me, I'ma put that ass in a box, G, cause I don't give two fucks about your punk. You may carry a 45, but yo, I pack a pump. And you can
still... That beat remind me of like an old...
So now...
Old break beat, yo.
He was referring to former mayor of District of Columbia, Marion Barry.
Marion Barry got caught smoking that shit.
In another rap song, I forgot who's... This is something we listen to often, too. I think it was a Wu-Tang. He said... Dinkins is watching Barry smoking crack. Something along those lines. It's another track with that.
Let's move on, man. Track number 9 is called Fuck a War. And this is a track where Bushwick Bill is actually talking about they try to recruit him for the war.
Gulf War.
And he's like, yo, man, I ain't going to your war.
He's not even tall enough to be shooting.
It's a song, sorry. It's a song. While we're here on Fuck a War, we gonna do some ratings, y'all. Let's do the ratings. So, y'all, only a few ratings this week. Not much. We got All Music giving it 4 stars out of 5 stars. Rolling Stones gave it 2 stars out of 5.
Fuck Rolling Stones.
Rap Reviews gave it a 9 out of 10. And Entertainment Weekly is back, baby.
They were back? They was gone.
Back after
a
hiatus.
What last week we had? Wow.
It was, but that's crazy, because... The album last week was way up later in life than earlier in life to them, but...
Hey, man, I don't care, man. They backside. Letters, where you going with?
They gave them a B.
Oh, what you going with?
I'm going to go with a C.
Entertainment Weekly gave him a B.
Oh.
So...
Not like I knew.
Good ratings except for Rolling Stones, guys.
Well,
Rolling
at that
Stones
time,
person.
Rolling Stones was only rolling with rock.
Rollins don't give him a 2 out of 5.
Yeah, they hate on the rap.
Alright, let's move on, man. Track number 10 on the album, if it's called Ain't With Being Broke. I like this track, yeah, too, man.
I think I can relate to this. This is life.
Who wants to be broke? Nobody wants to be broke, man.
Ain't with being broke, man. Right,
who versus this, huh?
We're going Bushwick Bill.
You know what? We actually get some variety in this album. We
spread around love a little bit, right?
I don't know what y'all was doing last week, but... Y'all gave 4 verses to 1 person and then 1 verse to
oh yeah.
Yeah, y'all was bugging out last week. Let's get it, man. Who this again?
Bushwick
Bill?
Last week was Lauren Hill?
Yeah.
Who just know, man. Last week was AT Aliens.
Uh-oh. Oh yeah. We gave it all to Drake. Actually, I didn't give it all. I was a marketer anyway.
Let's go, man.
I was born in a cheap ass hospital. Brought to the 5th Ward, stuck right in the middle of a rock in a hard spot. Before my dad got that ass, I was already counted out. What a motherfucking pity. Mommy couldn't afford milk, so we had to suck her titty. In the kitchen every night, I would see rats and roaches eating better than me. Wait a minute. Have you seen them? You gotta take that. You gotta hold
no,
on,
you gotta
mommy.
Eat that. What they in?
Nah. Hold up.
Hold on, y'all niggas gotta break me off first, man. Y'all need to watch out. There was no Thanksgiving. They say I'm a fool for thanking God for living. But being broke ain't no motherfucking joke. Well, out of 91, shit just ain't happening, bro. I never had a goddamn thing. Christmas came and went without a choo-choo train. And the ghetto's gifts get stolen on board. Ain't no motherfucking Santa Claus. That's
it. All right. Yo, this is track number 10, man. This is called Eat With Being Broke, yo. Let's get it. Broke.
I was born in a cheap-ass hospital. Broke the fifth ward, stuck right in the middle of a rock and a hard spot. Before my dad got that ass, I was already counted out. What a motherfucking pity. Mama couldn't afford milk, so we had to suck a titty. In the kitchen every night I would see rats and roaches eating better than me. There was no Thanksgiving. They say I'm a fool for thanking God for living. But being broke ain't no motherfucking joke. Without the 91, shit just ain't happening, bro. I never had a goddamn thing. Christmas came and went without a choo-choo train. In the ghetto's gifts get stolen, but ain't no motherfucking Santa Claus.
Let's move on. Track number 11 is called Quickie. And we had did an album. I forget which album we did some weeks back. And the sample on the album was from Impeach the President, the Honey Drippers. This track also uses the same sample. So seems like that sample was an ill sample. That song, Impeach the President. We've done a few that have sampled this song up to now. So the Honey Drippers, shout out to y'all, man. Y'all got the ill track. Track number 12 on the album is called Punk Bitch.
Punk Bitch
Game. So Punk Bitch Game is the name of that track. Second to last track on the album is called The Other Level. And while we're on this second to last track, this is another one of those albums where all of the members also did a solo song themselves. Mm-hmm. So while they did all songs together, each of them had at least a solo track for themselves on this album. On this song right here, Bushwick Bill is talking about trying to get these two girls to do a threesome.
She did talk about it
with him. So ill track, man. But we're gonna move into the final track of the album, which is called Trophy.
This song is a good representation of basically Grammys and all them other people that get to review our music and dictate who wins and who loses. Because they don't know shit about
it. You know what, though? I gotta say this, man. Shout out to all the old school artists that didn't go to the Grammy. Because there was a time when a lot of the big name artists, they stopped going to the Grammys. And we've actually seen change. There were years before when the rap, hip hop, used to get the reward, get there before the Grammys started.
Oh, no,
they
wouldn't even hear it, right. And they just put tonight's earlier winners.
Right. And now, these days, because of what those guys did, they know they're going to get a Grammy, they didn't go. They know they'll say, yeah, we're coming, and didn't show up. They protested, yo, y'all got to put our stuff. And now, rap, hip hop, best hip hop. All that stuff now is getting aired now on the Grammys because of their hard work, man. So shout out to all the pioneers that did their work. Now we're seeing the fruits of the label, man. So shout out to y'all, man.
You know what? Still F the Grammys because
it's still more to do.
People that listen to the music, a lot of them don't know the music.
I think that's the next step, oh. We got to get the people that's voting. Those old heads who voted that don't know about rap, they got to get out of there and bring people in there that know.
Who's voting for it is the one who's paying for it. So it's like,
nah, they need to change.
Get people in there that knows, that listens to the music, that knows the music.
So we're gonna start it off like this. Who gives a fuck about a goddamn Grammy?
I don't know.
Verse 1, Willie D. Yo, Flav, I give a fuck about a goddamn Grammy, but them motherfucking hoes won't hand me one. At least you was invited by the bigots. The motherfuckers told me to buy your ticket. So he's saying, yo, Flavor Flav. You know what I'm saying? This is the situation. Flavor Flav, Public Enemy. They got invited, but he didn't get invited. And they were selling records. You said number 24 on a Billboard 200.
And number 5 on the R&B.
Come on. Listen. To the phony-ass ceremony. Fuck Oscar, Emmy, and Tony. Because when it comes to award time, niggas be standing on goddamn sideline. I'm loading on my 9 because I got a lot of grudges. I'm about to take out the judges. Willie D won't shit ya, but hit ya. Take a look at the overall picture. Every year, it's the same old story. Same faces, same categories. I set a lot of records, and a lot of people know me. Now, where's my goddamn trophy? And let's go to the hook. And the winner is... Let me stop.
Yo, let's get it, man. Yo, final track on the album is track number 14. This track is called Trophy, y'all.
Yo, Flame, I give a fuck about a goddamn Flammy. But them motherfucking hoes won't have me one. At least you was invited by the biggest. The motherfuckers told me to buy a ticket to the phony ass ceremony. Fuck Oscar, Emmy, and Tony. Cause when it comes to award time, niggas be standing on the goddamn sideline. I'm number 9, cause I got a lot of grudges. I'm about to take out the judges. Willie D won't shit ya, but hit ya. Take a look at the overall picture. Every year it's the same old story. Same faces, same categories. I sold a lot of records and a lot of people know me. Now where's my goddamn trophy?
That's an ill.
Let me just say the little
sample too.
What they were saying the war, so
that sample sound familiar.
They was like, and the winner is Randy Travis and Guns. And hey, what the? Willie, he grabs the mic. Get the fuck out of the way. Get your ass out the goddamn way. Yo, man, the real motherfucking winner is goddamn Geto Boys. So most fuck words in the song. The bitch killer of the year Grammy goes to that nigga. You love to hate Ice Cube. The Nasty Ass Group Award goes to Two Live Crew. The High Roller of the Industry Award goes to Ice-T. The Pro Black Grammy goes out to Public Enemy.
P.E.
Because they too black and they too goddamn strong. And we're going to get a lip sync goddamn motherfucking Grammy to the punk motherfuckers, Milli Vanilli.
Really, they did win that, though. They did. Hey, they did win that
they
Grammy,
They did
though.
Win it, but... Was it known at 91?
No, that not that. No,
and that's crazy that they got Grammys. That's how whack the Grammys. They give Grammys to people that don't even deserve
Yo,
it.
Yo, man, hey, that's it, man.
Milli Vanilli needed that. Man. Yo, I love those guys.
Yo, man, that's it. End of the album, man. 14 tracks. We going to give it our vote. We going to come back at you. If it's good enough, y'all know what's going to happen. It's going to make it up on Fight Club, man. If it's not good enough, Scarface, man, we're going to mail this right back to you, y'all.
Geto Boy. Let's
back
go.
To y'all in a second.
In a big box.
Pow!
I like
Yo, we back, man. This is Rating of the Balls. And as you can see.
Ain't nothing changed.
Nothing changed up on Fight Club. Fight Club still stays the same. Geto Boy's album was not good enough to make it up on Fight Club. So, yo, Si, you want to go first? What you,
sure.
What you got?
I give it a 3.5.
3.5? Okay, pretty decent.
It's not, you know, what they lost. It's just how high they got them.
Okay, okay. Shoot. Give it to them.
It's early music, you know. The style back then, it really wasn't my thing. Like, the way they
We run. In New York City, man. You're going to hear ambulances all the time. That's just how it is out here in New York City.
We're organic.
Nah, it's a sound prop. Don't worry about that.
You know, it's like that earlier style, it really wasn't my style. It was more message music for me back then. Kind of, like, that's how I put it. You could quote me. The rhymes was good. You know, the production, it was clean. You know, but the music is not really my style of hip hop, I would say. But not to say it's bad music, you know, but that's just.
So it's safe to say you didn't buy this album when it came out? Or you don't own this album?
Nah.
Okay. Favorite MC from the group?
Scarface.
Best, most memorable track? Mind Paying Tricks on Me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Everybody know. But I mean, but after listening to this, what was it? The Trophies pretty much stuck with me. And
yeah, good track. Mm-hmm. Good message.
We Can't Be Stopped, pretty much. Two good tracks. It had, the music had a good message in it. And from their standpoint and what they were speaking about, is, you know, it's definitely music to listen to, but that's just where I'm at with it.
3.5? 3.5. Ah, yo. So, I give this album a 2.5.
I think that's a low number now. Did he give anything lower than that?
Nah, that's just, he breaks at 2.5.
I'm proud of 2.5.
He don't go. Okay. He respects him that much.
This one, man, I just couldn't get into it, man. And I'm a big Scarface fan. I think Scarface is one of the most lyrical MCs out there. But the album was just all over the place. I think the lyrics weren't up to par. Willie D and Bushwick Bill couldn't keep up with Scarface, man. Scarface had some good stuff on there, but even his material, to me, it wasn't as inspirational as some of his oldest, just newer stuff that came out after.
At this point in hip hop, it was opening the door still kind of thing.
This album felt like a Public Enemy album to me. I mean, and a lot of the beats, of the way they rhymed, I visualized P.E.
He sounded like Chuck D a little bit. The way they say things towards you.
But there are some standout tracks, like Si said. Mind Playing Tricks on Me is still a super classic. Trophy was a standout track to me also. Homie Don't Play That was a pretty good track too. What else? And actually, Bushwick Bill's Fuck a War was actually a good track to me too. So, very uninspirational album. But I still will listen to a few tracks on here. So, that's it, man. Scarface, shout out to you still. You're still one of my favorite MCs. But this album just wasn't hitting it for me. Middle of the road for me. 2.5.
That sounds like the bottom to me.
That's not the bottom. You always say 2.5 is half a five.
I never say that.
Yes, you always said 2.5 is in the middle. That's what you were saying.
2.5 seems kind of disrespectful. But you know what? That's what you gave him. And anybody in Texas, anybody that's fans of Geto Boys, you can leave him a comment on Slack.
Scarface is still my man.
That's cool, but y'all can leave him a comment, okay?
What you got for him, O?
This album right here was groundbreaking, okay? I'm going to start off by saying look at Chief's face like a
soft. He dropped it on the concrete break.
Listen, this album at the time, 1991, picture it. These guys are coming out. They're talking about all the things that you want to hear from rap group back in the days. They're talking about injustice going on the streets. They're talking about fuck the police. They're talking about black people problems. You know what I'm saying? BBD, man. That alone right there should get them at least a 3. You can't be. And they came out in 91. This wasn't no commercial album.
The way they wound on the album, it wasn't cohesive.
The only song, and they wasn't even trying to make commercials, my mind playing trick. They didn't put nothing out for the radio. This was just a straight up album you bump. I guess if you was in Texas or if it ever made it to New York, if a cousin or somebody came up there and told you about them because you might not known about them, you know what I'm saying? It was hardcore. It was some shit, man. You know, check the ratings for the album, bro. A lot of ratings is good for this.
Let's go to the ratings.
Not your 3 ratings, man. You got to go on the internet. Go to Google or something, man. You know what I'm saying? Your ratings wasn't good enough, man.
All right, let's get it.
But I like a lot of tracks. I like My Mind Playing Tricks on Me, of course.
Mm-hmm.
I like Trophy. I like Quickie. We didn't use Quickie. Quickie's a good one. You know, talks about.
And again, that's the track that they sampled in Peace of President, which that track was sampled a lot in hip hop. So
yeah, that's a regular.
2,000 times almost.
What's the other track with Bushwick and the two girls having a threesome?
Trophy. I don't know. That was the other.
Whatever that track.
The other level.
Other level? Oh, yeah, the other level. You know what I'm saying? Gotta Let Your Nuts Hang. That song right there is just like telling you what it is, how you gotta move about. You know what I'm saying? To me, at the time, I never had the album because I was just like a little snot-nosed kid running around.
I'm a
snot-nosed man walking around.
No.
He has a car.
Yes. This album's pretty good, man. I think it deserves at least a 4. I gave it a 4. You know what I'm saying?
4. Strong. Boy, big numbers from y'all, man. You guys enjoy this album.
Yo, first of all, music is subjective, okay? What you like and what I like.
You always tell me 2.5 is the middle. That's the middle. That's not low.
I never said that.
You always said it's not a low.
3 is maybe the middle. I mean, obviously 2.5 is the middle. 5, but.
Favorite song on the album?
Mathis.
My Mind Playing Tricks on Me.
All right. Would you bump this album right now all the way through, or would you skip through some tracks?
I probably skip through like One or two tracks. All right. I mean, I bumped it this week. I've been bumping it all week. You know, before we do the show, we got to, you know, fine tune it.
Refresh.
So yeah. I've been bumping it. I just let it play out because there's no point of skipping a song. I just want to hear it, how it's given to
refresh
me.
Refresh your mind.
Yeah, man. It's a good album, man. It's not going to make the list, but, you know, shout out to Geto Boys. Y'all did y'all thing. And once again, hopefully, praise are up for Bushwick Bill. He pulls through. Yeah.
All right, let's move into the final segment of the show, which is called Balls of the Titan.
I gotta get back to the chair, man. These things are deflating right now. I gotta get back pumping, man.
This week,
I've been trying to get to the Y for the longest, yo.
This week, we're gonna say a rest in peace because this MC was one of the greatest MCs coming out of New York City.
In your top 10?
This group is in my top 3. Of hip hop groups.
Is he in your
top
10?
No, he's not in my top 10.
Wow, your top 10 is hard to get in.
Yes.
Okay.
But this group is in my top 3. And we're talking about the late, great, the King of New York himself, Queensbridge finest, Mr. Prodigy.
Bandana P.
Rest in peace. Off of this. This track is off of the HNIC album, his first solo album outside the group. Right, oh?
Yep.
First solo.
And I see Head Nigga in Charge.
And this track is called Keeping It Thorough. But before we give you all the tracks, Si, what you got for the people?
Listening to the words of man is cancerous. It could infect the brain with false narratives of what's going on. So learn to go through that book yourself. You know, don't take another man's his word or his.
What if the man that wrote the book wrote cancerous words in the book?
Well, you would have to know what's in the book.
Have to read the book yourself.
Read the book yourself.
Oh, Bugs, what's in the Serato? What are you bumping on title, man?
Just got the Future album. I'm not gonna say nothing. Just came out days ago.
Chris Brown just dropped a new single
with Drake. That single you talking about?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that shit's all right.
What else you got?
I had to go back, started bumping my nigga Nas. It was written.
Yo, Nas got a large catalog, man.
You can always go back.
That's
a large catalog
to choose from.
Why don't you listen to Nostradamus?
That wasn't a bad album.
It's just certain songs. That was supposed to be a double CD, but nah.
It's iffy, right?
So that's it, oh? No new albums come out? Nothing else?
Nah, that's pretty much it.
Yo, shout out to that boy Jim Jones album, yo. It's
Capo?
Tough. It's tough. It's tough. Okay. You know, it's not the greatest, but...
It's better than Wasted Talent? You better don't go there, man. What? Don't even go there.
Don't go there, Si. I wouldn't say it's better. It's a follow-up. Okay. It's like how Styles P with the dime bag and all that. It's a follow-up. He's like on like, get it out your system. Right
Waste
now.
Of Talent. Shout out. Good album. Let's get this verse side. This is called Keeping It Thorough.
Dun, 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 dun. Everybody know when this song comes out. Prodigy. You already know. Just by the beat itself. He goes, yo, I break bread.
Ribs. $100 bills.
Peel on Ducatis.
Another four wheels.
I write a book full of medicine and generate mills.
Tour the album only for more sales.
We used to catch does on the block with krills. Used to catch sales on the block.
Yeah, man. We from New York, man. We get it, man. Go ahead.
The audience, you know?
All right.
Now it's paid shows. Promoters post up bills.
Mm-hmm. Sign deals only if the math is real.
If you can't catch math numbers, then you can't have the head nigga in charge and shit. Live nigga rhyme artist. Pardon. P-Dub Shine regardless. Remorseless. Haunt niggas like pork to dice.
My advice for it get like this, to think twice.
For you move on it, put jewels on it.
Who want it?
Loose niggas make the news.
When we start forming.
Snatch stripes off niggas' uniform often. Don't embarrass yourself. Don't embarrass your delf. You weigh out your jurisdiction while niggas bullshit on the grill. I don't fuck around, dummy.
It's smooth still, I keep it thorough, nigga. Yo, this verse is legendary, yo. This is a legendary verse. This is a legendary album, too, man. HNIC Volume 1, man. Yo, Side of God is there. That's Old Bugs. It's your boy Onslaught Tree again. Rest in peace to the God Prodigy. This is off his first album, HNIC. This track is called Keeping It Thorough. We're going to see y'all next week. Peace. Pull it, nigga.
Hey, yo. I break bread, ribs, $100 bills, peel on the cotties, another four wheels, write a book full of medicine and generate meals, tour the album, only for more sales, we used to catch those on the block with krills, now it's paid shows, promoters post up bills, sign deals only if the math is real, if we can't match numbers then you can't have the head nigga in charge of shit. Live nigga rhymes artists, pardon, P-Dub shines regardless, remorseless, haunt niggas like poltergeist, my advice for a get like that, just think twice before you move on it, put jewels on it, who want it, loose niggas make the news when we start forming, snatch stripes off of niggas uniforms often, doing it past it though, if you way out the jurisdiction, why niggas bullshit on the grill, I don't fuck around, Dunny, it's most real, I keep it thorough, nigga. Yo, let me back up for him, let me back up, yo, yo. Why niggas bullshit on the grill?